Hello guys, welcome back to another reaction video here on Our Eyes, Your Eyes. I'm ready to watch episode 16 of Steins Gate, season 1. But before starting this video, I just want to remind you to subscribe to the channel, click on the notification bell, leave a like to support me, and join me in this super beautiful adventure. Okay, now we need to understand where this badge is coming from. And we need to understand also if they can fix the time machine. Are you ready to join me with these? Check it out. Barrel titer, yeah. Yeah, because that was his nickname. Taro. No, look, I was telling you this, that's Daru! Here we go again. No, but I still believe that he is her dad. Yeah, because in the other timeline he was saying that. Yeah. Hey, I told you, I think that's her dad. Exactly. What if? Yeah. But even if he's going back in time, things are repeating the same. That's the same thing she was saying before. I am not convinced. Is it Daru or Kyoma the dead? She has the same expression as Mayurio. He's anticipating what she wanted to say. No. No. No, no, absolutely no. Maybe you can live even better, trust me, than 2036. But But even Kilma is feeling a deep attachment to this girl, so that's why I'm confused. That's another time in which they are having this eye contact. Maybe Mayuri remembers that Kyoma was using that title for something. Maybe Mayuri saw that number already somewhere with those letters. Oh my, I'm confused. I love that. Daru! Yes! No, it's not fun! It's true! She found that number. Yeah. Yeah, I thought the same. No. Exactly. Exactly. Yes. The number. Yes. Second. It's you. Oh my, look! Oh my! Wow! Oh my! I'm so happy. Daru, I mean. No, that's cruel. No, I think she will never forget. Yeah. Hey, but she can't come back. No. Emma, yes, we know that she can't come back. Because they were saying it at the beginning of the episode. In fact, that's why Kyoma was keeping asking her, don't you regret your memories, don't you regret that? Goodbye. Yeah, I hope that too. The satellite. Maybe.
Possibility?
Yes! And Bakioma is pretty sad because of that, I guess. Wow. Yeah. Who's there? No, it's not her. I don't think it's her. What? What? No, look, I have an idea. Okay. No, later I'm going to tell you what I think. Yes. Now, Kiyoma feels terrible. No, no, now Kiyoma feels so terrible. I mean, he feels that it's all his fault. Yeah, because he feels responsible. Yeah. Exactly. It was a friend. That's why she was writing Shippaishita, Shippaishita, Shippaishita. Yeah. Hey, I told you. Yeah. Yeah, it feels as if he has to do it. In fact, she was really kind. Because she knew who you are. Yeah. Yes, he knows. Yeah, exactly, not yet. Oh, she's there. Maybe a little bit. I hope so. Oof, what an incredible episode. Look, I want to start with the idea that I got by watching this episode. And of course, I think that it's wrong. But I just wanted to share it with you so you understand where sometimes my mind goes. At a certain point, I thought that Suzu-chan was Moeka. I mean, why did I think something like this? Is because I have always thought that Moeka was coming from the past, and she was also unable, or she was surprised, she was amazed by checking this cell phone as if she didn't know what that thing was. And she seemed strange. I mean, she didn't even want to talk. She was always looking for this computer too. I know that it's wrong, but I found some connections between Suzu-chan and her, because both of them, they were desperately searching for this computer. Both of them, they seemed to me that they were coming from the past, in this case when Suzu-chan is going back in the past. And they also have the same hair color, so I was thinking, what if Moeka doesn't even know that she was a Suzu-chan or something like that? I don't know, but I just felt that. And then when, of course, we discover what happened to Suzu-chan, I was so sad, because Okarin, I mean Kyoma, right now feels so guilty. Because he feels as if he was asking Suzu-chan to end her life, to sacrifice her life for the sake of Mayuri's life. And I think that if Mayuri knows that, she feels so incredibly guilty for this, and she would have never accepted this. I think that for the fact that Mayuri doesn't even know everything that is happening, because Mayuri doesn't know that she's going to be killed soon, Mayuri doesn't know that Okarin is trying his best to find a solution to save her. Mayuri also lost her memories regarding Suzu-chan because Kyoma was sending this email. So the fact that she's surviving and another person was dying because of her, because she was a mere sacrifice from Kyoma's point of view, that's really terrible. And it's like as if Kyoma right now feels dirty, because he was always asking her, please, does this mean that I can save Mayuri? And she said, maybe. And actually it happened, because something changed since we understood what happened. And I feel sorry, because at least Suzu-chan had the chance to meet her dad, to hug him, and to feel complete from that point of view. But from the other point of view, she felt as if, she failed. Because her mission was to change the future, but she couldn't. And I really like the fact that right now, Kyoma has to find a way, another way to save her, because I don't think that he will never try to do something like this. I don't think that he will just stay in this condition without doing anything and wait that something can go ahead as it is. No, I think that if I know Kyoma a little bit, he definitely tries his best, no matter what, to try once again to solve all this. I don't know, let's see. But the fact that right now this timer has changed, it's like as if the world changed a little bit, but we don't know if it changed just because of Mayuri's sake, or it's changing in general, because actually the main purpose of what happened was to save Mayuri's life. So what if just that changed and the rest is the same? As soon as we got in touch with a little bit of truth, now we lost a comrade, we lost a person that was pretty useful, that could have told us many other things. And I understand Kyoma, I understand why he feels guilty, definitely, because if that day he didn't stop her, maybe right now the mission was succeeding instead of failing. But I think Kyoma doesn't have to feel guilty because of this, because his purpose, his intention was good, and he didn't even imagine that things could have been gone like this. I don't think that he should feel as he feels right now. But of course it's comprehensible, the fact that he feels like this, because everything seems that it was started by him, because of his intention, because of his desire, his wish to save Mayuri. And I understand also the fact that he tries to go back in time, because maybe he thinks that he prefers to erase the memories from all of them instead of understanding everything that happened to her. Or maybe the other option is that he wants to go back in time with the email to try to save her somehow, or to change things anyway. But we know that in the moment in which he's coming back in time, he is having another answer from Mr. Brown, because Mr. Brown is saying that the cause of her death was something else. It was an illness, instead of saying that it was a suicide. Then he is discovering in that world line that he is living right now that Mayuri is still safe. So her sacrifice meant something at the end of the day. It was not meaningless. But anyway, it's pretty sad to see that because of this bad future that is about to happen, things have to go on like this. I mean, I think that Kyoma feels as if his initial plan to change the future, that it was starting as a joke, as I was telling you even in the previous commentary, it's no more a joke. It's something pretty serious, and Kyoma has never imagined that to reach this point. And now it's like as if he is the one and only who's remembering everything, as if this guilt that he has to go ahead with him only. Because in the case all the others remembered, even all the others were cursed by this situation. But I admire Kyoma because he wants to fulfill this mission without other people suffering, without letting other people suffering, because he started everything. So he also said, it's all my fault. And that's why he's the only one remembering every time what's going on. I think that's the fair price to pay when you try something so dangerous. And let me tell you honestly, if you remember, Kyoma was saying Mayuri is the only one who's understanding the lab so clearly. And in fact, when he was trying to send the email, he was discovered by Mayuri because Mayuri was saying, are you going to send the email? And she was spitting out the truth of what could have happened later. That means to erase all these memories from all their minds regarding Suzu-chan. And he was keep saying, I know that, but I think that he felt that he had to do that because otherwise he would have felt even more guilty than what he is feeling right now. But he is right, because Mayuri is perceiving things in a different way, but she is sometimes the key of discovering things, of understanding something that might happen, or an important discovery like the fact that Suzu-chan's dad is Daru, because she understood from that number plus the letters that Daru was the creator of the time machine. And if Mayuri was not there, probably Suzu-chan was going back in the past and have her destiny destroyed without even knowing who her father was. So it's all thanks to Mayuri in this case that Suzu-chan had the chance to hug her dad before reaching 1975 and reaching her death somehow. So as you can see, all these characters are playing a great role. There is not even one character that is meaningless. And even if sometimes a character is emerging a little bit later, that doesn't mean that they are useless. Totally the contrary. Look at Daru. At the beginning, we thought that he was just a comrade of Kyoma, a teammate of this club, a strange club, but then we understand that he created the time machine. He was the one who brought, unconsciously speaking, Suzu-chan in 2010, and he was pretty essential because they had the chance to confirm themselves that time traveling is proper, that is real, that it can happen. And we could have never expected this at the beginning of the story, and that's why this story is pretty awesome, because there are things happening that you don't even understand. Regarding Moika, that is not appearing anymore, and I hope that she will appear once again really soon, Moika is still a question mark, because we know that she is a part of the CERN organization, but we know that even Chris is a part of the CERN organization in the future. So, as you can see, the more we are changing these world lines, the more things are changing even for an instance, even for 1 second. And this timer that Suzu-chan had didn't change it to 1%. But I'm pretty sure that they will do their best to reach it, also because they wanted to avenge, let's say, Suzu-chan's death because of everything that happened. Especially because, as I was telling you, Kyoma will find a way, definitely a way, to solve all this. Because now, this mission that Suzu-chan had is passed to Kyoma. Because now Kyoma is the one who has to try to change the future. The risk is high. But I know that Kyoma is not stopping trying, And that's the greatness of this character. No matter the hardship that he's still feeling because of everything that is happening, he keeps trying. And I understand Mayuri-chan's feelings. I understand that she's afraid. And as soon as we are going ahead with all these, Mayuri-chan was saying in previous episodes that she's afraid that she's going to lose Kyoma. And in fact, we know that in the future, Kyoma is dead. I mean, he's not even reaching 2036. But the most important thing is to try to reach the goal, no matter the hardship, no matter the difficulty. So I think that he will do that. But what's the price for that? Is Mayuri-chan dead too in the future? Or now that the world changed a little bit, that there is the chance that they are not gone in 2036? We will understand it just by looking, just by going ahead and watch this. Okay, guys, I think that for this episode, that is it. I hope you enjoyed and stay tuned because next week I come back with episode 17 of this first season of Steins Gate. In the meantime, feel free to subscribe to the channel and click on the notification bell. Bye, guys. See you in the next video.